Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Many people naively define unity as consensus of opinion. This definition is flawed simply because the noble companions radiyallahu anhum differed in their views, but their hearts were united. In fact, I often say their hearts were more united amidst their differing views than our hearts can possibly be united when we have consensus of opinion. One would assume that on the passing away of an erudite scholar, notwithstanding the differences, a person would pay tribute, homage, and extol the praises of the late scholar. And that is precisely what we learn from the noble companions, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. We often speak about the rich accomplishments and the accolades of Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, and rightfully so. It is no secret that Sayyidina Muawiyah radiallahu anhu and Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu had different views, and the views were significantly different. Nay, if you look into the very campaign and expedition of Siffin, you will know the details. Yet when Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu was assassinated, Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu anhu asks someone to praise Ali radiallahu anhu in his presence. We live in such a sad time that we don't have the courage to praise a scholar with whom we differ. And when others praise him, it becomes difficult for us to digest the praises. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu is assassinated. Dhirar bin Dhamra al-Kinani radiallahu anhu comes to visit Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. Muawiyah radiallahu anhu says, Sifli Aliya. Oh Dhirar, describe Ali radiallahu anhu to me. Yesterday in the campaign of Siffin, a fight took place, differences occurred, but look at how clean and how pure the hearts were. Allahu Akbar. So Dhirar radiallahu anhu tells Ali radiallahu anhu, Awa tu'fini ya Amir al-Mu'minin. Oh Amir al-Mu'minin, please excuse me. Sayyidina Muawiyah radiallahu anhu says, No, I insist and persist that you enumerate the accolades, the feat, the accomplishment of Ali radiallahu anhu. So he says, كان والله بعيد المدى شديد القوى يقول فصلا ويحكم عدلا يتفجر العلم من جوانبه وتنطق الحكمة من نواحيه يستوحش من الدنيا وزهرتها يستأنس بالليل وظلمته كان والله غزير العبر طويل الفكرة يقلب كفه ويخاطب نفسه يعجبه من اللباس ما قصر ومن الطعام ما جشب لا إله إلا الله. These are the praises, and each one of them are voluminous in its own capacity. That Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu was one, يَتَفَجَّرُ الْعِلْمُ مِنْ جَوَانِبِهِ. Knowledge would burst from every limb of his. Knowledge would burst from every limb of his. Of course, there's no comparison to the knowledge of Ali radiallahu anhu or the knowledge of Sahaba for that matter. But again, I say in contemporary times, in paying homage and tribute and extolling the praises of the late Mufti Taha rahimahullah, he was a man, whenever he spoke, knowledge was bursting forth. And then he goes on to say, Ali radiallahu anhu was that man, yuqallibu kaffahu, he would rotate his palm, and yukhatibu nafsahu, he would address himself, yu'jibuhu min al-libasi ma qasur wa min al-ta'ami ma jashub, he ate simple food, he was humble by demeanor. Subhanallah, when Sayyidina Muawiyah radiallahu anhu heard the praises of Ali, فَوَكَفَتْ دُمُوعُ مُعَاوِيَةَ عَلَىٰ لِحْيَتِهِ مَا يَمْلِكُهَا. Sayyidina Muawiyah radiallahu anhu was weeping so profusely that his blessed beard was drenched with tears. مَا يَمْلِكُهَا. He could not contain his outburst of emotions. Now we speak fondly about Sahaba, and we have the jalsas of Sahaba, and rightfully so. But subhanallah, this is how they would navigate their differences. This is how clean their hearts were. He could not contain his tears. وَجَعَلَ يُنَشِّفُهَا بِكُمِّهِ. He took his sleeve and then he started wiping his tears. وَاخْتَنَقَ الْقَوْمُ بِالْبُكَى. And the entire congregation was choked with tears. And he said, هَكَذَا كَانَ أَبُو الْحَسَنِ. Indeed, that's an apt reflection and description of Ali radiallahu anhu. And then he said, Dhirar, what is your grief after the demise? What is your pain and your sorrow after the demise of Ali radiallahu anhu? So Dhirar radiallahu anhu said, وَجْدُ مَنْ ذُبِحَ وَاحِدُهَا فِي حِجْرِهَا لَا تَرْقَأُ دَمْعَتُهَا وَلَا يَسْكُنُ حُزْنُهَا. My anguish, my pain, my sorrow after the demise of Ali radiallahu anhu is like a woman whose only child was slaughtered cold-blooded in her lap. Her tear doesn't dry up and her anguish does not wither. That was unity. That was unity. The muhabba of the hearts. May Allah bless the ummah with true unity. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen.